Hi everyone, welcome to the new Nicko's Kitchen. I've been away for a while because I have been moving home, and check this out behind me. If you want me to do a full kitchen, maybe even a house tour, then just drop a comment below and let me know if you want to see that. This kitchen is so beautiful. It is what cooks dream of. It is so easy to use and I'm just loving it. So I'm hoping you enjoy all the food that comes out of this kitchen that came out of the old one for the last 10 years. So what am I making today? I'm making this beautiful salmon dish, smoked salmon, with beets, dill, and fennel salad, and tarting it up with a little bit of caviar just to make it that extra special. Now, I love smoked fish. I had a lot of smoked fish when I was growing up as a kid. My mum used to make a lot of it, and I think it's a fantastic way to cook. It's really healthy, it's full of flavor, and it's easy to do. It's even easier nowadays because most fishmongers actually do it for you. If you go to the local fish market and say, hey, can you smoke this for me? Or they may even have something that's been previously smoked, then buy it. It is so, so good. And you know I'm cooking a lot healthier these days and involving different styles of diets, whether it be keto, low carb, no sugar, that sort of thing. And this dish does fit into that category. So firstly, what we're gonna do is roast our beets. So really simply, just onto a tray with some foil, I place down the beet, give it a little bit of olive oil, and then just season with salt. This is so simple. Wrap it up with that foil and place it into a hot oven, 180 degrees or 350 Fahrenheit, and give it 40 to 45 minutes. And then all you have to do after that, put on some gloves, peel back the skin and just leave it to cool. That's it. Now, I would suggest staying away from canned beets because you can find so much sugar in them. Canned ones are much sweeter. I don't want that. I'm after that real earthiness of the beetroot. And the next thing I'm gonna do to go into the salad is boil some eggs. Great protein, the perfect protein. So easy, hard-boiled eggs is what I'm after because I'm gonna chop them up and put them in the salad. So you know the drill, cold water, eggs go in, bring it up to a boil, and cook them until they're hard-boiled. For me, it always takes about 8 minutes. And then I just shell them under some running water, and there you have perfect hard-boiled eggs, every time. The next ingredient not a lot of people are a fan of because of the aniseed flavor, but I absolutely love it and it goes so well with this dish. I'm using some fennel. So you wanna discard the leaves on the top, and it's a bit like an onion, just peel back the outer layer. Cut it so we've got a nice flat side, and then using a mandolin, I'm going to very carefully slice it into thin pieces. Now, when you slice it, you're not gonna get round pieces of fennel. What you will get are these beautiful, almost ribbon thin. And the great thing about getting the fennel really thin is that licorice aniseed flavor doesn't really come through too strong, but it's there and it's just enough to make you go, yum. So I'm gonna make a salad out of this mix. So what I'm gonna do into a bowl is add in some whole egg mayonnaise, and then to that I'm gonna add in the fennel, I'm gonna add in some dill, I'm gonna season it with some salt and pepper, of course the egg. Now into the salad, I want a real citrus spark. So what I'm gonna be placing in is some preserved lemons. You can buy this in the stores, so easy, and it is such a lovely accompaniment in this salad. It really gives it a nice fresh zing. And then I'm just gonna mix it all around, get it well combined, and the flavors in this little salad, this little egg mayonnaise salad, are just to die for. So easy, so simple. And this whole dish is served at room temperature. So you don't have to worry about hot, warm mayonnaise or cold mayonnaise or anything like that. This whole dish is served at room temp. So to go with our salad, I'm gonna make another very quick little salad with the beets that we cooked before. I've cut them and I'm adding in some rocket or arugula, and it's got a wonderful peppery taste to it. Goes fantastically well with the beets with that earthy flavor. Just give it a little drizzle of olive oil, mix it around, and then you wanna bring everything together. So onto a plate, I'm gonna place down our egg and fennel salad. On top of that, I've got our smoked salmon, and the smoked salmon I've got is just delicious. It's not those thin layers. It's a whole fillet of salmon that's been smoked. I've cut it up and just have a look at it. I've also got rid of the skin as well. I don't want the skin. I want it peeled off, and it's really easy when it's smoked. Underneath, you just peel off that layer and then place down the salmon on top of that fennel salad. Next to it, we're gonna place the beets and arugula or rocket. Now the dish has got some crunchiness with that fresh fennel, but I need something more. So what I'm gonna do is sprinkle over some sunflower seeds. Really, really good for you, and just gives an added texture, a crunch, which this dish just is singing out for and deserves. And right at the end, we're just gonna tart this up with some caviar. Now this is lumpfish caviar, poor man's caviar, but I absolutely love it. It's got the look of caviar. It just gives the whole dish a little bit of saltiness to it as well, and a little bit of class. Don't tell anyone and they'll think it's the real thing. And I think the color with the salmon goes really, really well. You could use salmon roe as well. They're a little bit bigger. Give it a drizzle of olive oil all over, a splash of lemon juice, some extra dill over the top, and you have the most amazing, quick, healthy lunch or dinner that you could ask for. It is so good, packed with flavor. So please give this one a try. I reckon you're gonna love it. It is the first dish coming out of the new kitchen, so it's gotta be good. The recipe you can find in the description below, link to my website, check it out. Share this around with your family and friends. Give it a like if you love this video, and I'll see you real soon for another recipe.